But we just running around, chasing the lettuce. I bought a Bentley, still feel pathetic. Glass in my wrist, severe depression, music my therapy.
Good morning and welcome to another day in the life video. You catch me in bed at 9:30 because I didn't manage to finish this lecture that I wanted to last night at the library. So I'm having to do it this morning. Lectures are supposed to be around 50 minutes long, maybe an hour, which is manageable. But this one happens to be about an hour and a half, so 40 minutes longer than it should be, which is why it's taking so long. I saw 50 minutes pop up at the bottom and I was like, yay, you know, it's only 50 minutes long. But then there was a second part to the lecture, which is half an hour long. So, not great. However, for the first time since I think I've arrived at university, I'm working before breakfast. And it's because I've done something that I haven't done before. I've decided to not go on my phone in the morning before starting work. So my alarm went off and I just threw my phone across the room. It's now on the floor because I just don't want to have to check anything, especially considering that it's Black Friday at the moment and I don't want to be looking at all those sweet, sweet deals on Amazon this early in the morning. Instead, I'm doing some contract law, which of course is good fun. So I think I'm going to use today as a day to get all those small tasks that have started building up done. So if I haven't quite finished the lecture, or I need to do a few more pages of reading to make sure that I finished a section of the course, I'm going to get that done today. I also have to start preparing for two formative essays that I have due in the next 2 weeks. The difference between summatives and formatives, I don't know if it's the same at every university, I assume it is, but here at Durham, a summative is something that counts towards your final mark that year, and a formative doesn't count towards your final mark. It's really only used to give you feedback. And obviously because I've never studied law before, it's quite good to get that feedback. Because I haven't written an essay in many months, I've needed to sort of get those skills back again. I'm also going to try to get two or three more lectures done today. But luckily I have an evening slot at the Biddy Bee, which is our main university library, this evening until 10:30. So I'm going to try and do one or two lectures during that time. And then obviously to get some exercise in, I'm going to try to go for a run today and organise a call with someone who actually watches these videos who wants to know a bit more about studying law at Durham. So I'm going to try and set up a time to call him. Maybe today. We'll see how the day goes. My breakfast time slot is at 10. And obviously, if I miss it, I miss breakfast. That's one of the drawbacks of being in catered accommodation. I mean, there's a lot of benefits, but that is one of the drawbacks. Maybe later I'll talk about the differences between the two and why I think that being catered for, especially in first year, is such a good thing. But for now, I'm going to get dressed, put something decent on, and then we're going to head to breakfast. I'm away at 3 a.m. Hesitate to tell you that I need a break from this break. I wanna see you light my phone up. Where are you? With him? With your friends? I don't have friends. You're my only friend. You are my only friend. And if I say I'm fine, I've just found out some great news. All of my formatives have been extended. The deadlines have been extended by a week to allow us to travel home, even though, I mean, we're all gonna be traveling over one day, but I guess to allow everyone to have that one day, they've extended the deadline by a week. So the ones that I have due in on the 4th of December are now pushed back by a week and everything after that as well. So I'm in a pretty good mood today. I feel like today is going to be a good day. It's going to be productive because it means that I don't have to focus on these formatives as much, which means that I can prepare for the tutorials that I have next week. I've got 3 tutorials next week. I think one or two of them are in person, maybe, or maybe they've made them all online. I'm unsure. But yeah, honestly, the atmosphere feels pretty decent. Everyone's very tired, but they're looking forward to Christmas. But I think more importantly than Christmas,
they're looking forward to the end of lockdown. However, it's a bit of a double-edged sword because it might be the end of lockdown, but we're probably going to be put into tier three of restrictions, which is honestly, it's basically lockdown again. But yeah, honestly, I'm just quite happy. all my deadlines have been extended by a week. It really is a Christmas miracle. So for now, what I think that I'm going to do is get ready, have a shower, and then probably go down to the Hatfield Cafe. I want to try and get the next lecture that I have done today, which is INS, Individual in the State, and then I'll be happy. Two lectures, that's good. If I said I'm fine, I'm lying, I want to be yours again, amen. Right, so I'm all ready to face the day. We're going to go see if there is some space at the cafe and hopefully get some proper focused studying in. Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. 20. Nike crossbody, got a piece. Got a dance, but it's really on some street shit. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna? Right, so I've just taken a quick break, and now I'm sad because Kent is also going to be in tier 3 restrictions, so I can't escape it. Kent is in tier 3, Durham's in tier 3. Whether I go home or not doesn't change the restrictions, so it's quite sad. I thought I'd be able to escape them, but I guess not. Dance with me, no, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you the passion. It's a thriller in a track, where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfied.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, no, we out here.
Yes, please. Thank you.
It. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. 2,000 shorties wanna tie the knot. 200 shooters on my brother's block.
You're not a YouTuber.
I need a camera with a flip up the screen.
Do you not have one?
Well, I think the big one is. The whole of Kent is tier 3.
I know, I heard.
Even though my town has the lowest infection rate of the whole country.
Why is it tier 3 then?
Because it's the whole of Kent, then they haven't done it by town. Districts. Huh. It's now 4:30. And since I last spoke, I've just been doing some lecture reading for tort law. Here's my little shelf of books. It's the first Christmas that I'm 18 and I can't go to the pub with my mates when I see them again. I haven't seen them for, you know, a few months now since coming here. So it would be nice to go to the pub for a drink with them. But I guess that's just not something that we can do this year. So yeah, for this evening, I'm going to spend a bit more time now doing some more reading. Then at around 6 o'clock, I'm gonna go for a run. It's only a small run. The route that I do is about 1.7 miles long, so not even 2 miles. I've always been a sprinter. I've never done long distance, so it's good to try and build up my endurance. So this evening, I'm gonna go for a run. Then we'll have dinner at 7:10 because that's my dinner slot at Hatfield. Then I'll come back here, get my stuff, then head off to the library, the Billy B, which is our main university library. But for now, I'm going to continue with my reading, so I'll catch you in a bit. Honestly, I'm not feeling great about this run, because I don't want to admit it, but I did just eat half a pack of Doritos. And not a small pack, one of those big sharing packs. Because my mum thought that it would be a good idea to send me a bunch of these big packs of crisps. So obviously, I wanted to appreciate her gift, so I had to dig into them. So I'll probably be quite a bit slower than the other evenings, but at least I'll have done some exercise today. I haven't really been out other than to study. That's really the only reason anyone goes out at the moment is to study, because everything's closed. We're still in lockdown. And even when we leave, even when lockdown ends, we'll still be in tier 3 and basically everything will still be closed. So, fun. I do whatever I want, whenever I want, I love it.
People keep talking, I just keep winning. I'm just like, fuck it. They talking reckless.
One of the things about running in Durham is the sheer number of hills there are here. So it's quite intense. Even though the distance might not be as long as some other places, it's more intense.
I don't believe them, I think they bluffing. They just be talking, they just want clout. I'm just so vibing, I'm just like, fuck it. Yeah. Everybody trying to get a rise out of me. Escrow's trying to get a high out of me. I don't talk bad.
Another thing is that I enjoy running in the evenings. And there's some really nice runs nearby the river. But there are no lights there. So you can't really run because you're blind. You can't see anything. It just means that you have to stick to the main pavements.
Unless you're worthy. Hanging plaques up like jerseys. 25 extra lies on me. My family relies on me.
It's very empty in the evenings, but I'll be back this evening to go to the library.
3-5 stars at my home though. Walk around in slippers and robes though. They ain't a pole in the cold. The industry full of some hoes. They letting like anything go. People are shady as fuck. I keep to myself, but I feel the energy though. None of these people
actually managed to do it quicker somehow. 17 minutes. Pretty decent. All done. Although I am unfit because I have no stamina whatsoever, what gives out first is actually my throat. The cold air, because it's so cold here in Durham that my throat sort of like, I don't know how to describe it, it's all like painful because of the cold. And that occurs before like I get a stitch or I feel tired. So that's a limiting factor. I'm just gonna go quickly have a shower, get dressed for dinner. Have dinner, hopefully it's decent. Then as I said on the run, we'll go back to where we were, which is where the library is.
I got burdens on my shoulders. If I fold it, they gon' stay. At the time, I pass the time, just getting up and out the way. Use the disco, do some music, get my penny.
Dinner was pretty good, and before I head over to the library, I'm gonna relax a little bit and watch some YouTube, and then once I relax a little bit, I feel a bit more refreshed, then we'll head to the library. That's what the evening is looking like.
Can we get stands like K-pop? Can we set trends like they lie? Never let whiteies take my. Tell them I'm doing what they want. Roll it up, then I face one. In the background, no change, yeah. Back in the back, that's sat with the bag on.
Soaring high, golden skies. Reoccurring daydreams. Take your life, change your mind. Imagine northern daydreams.
Perfectly honest, I have no idea where I am or how to get out of here. Alright, so I'm pretty sure that this is not the staircase I'm supposed to be using. No, there's no way, I'm too high. I don't know if you can see it outside. There's no way. Oh no.
Empty my bank account and risk it all. Spend all my money on a brand new road. Play every chord until my fingers broke. I gotta.
I'll be perfectly honest, I did not think I was gonna be able to get out of there without asking someone. I mean, honestly, it was just following the signs. But there are so many like one-way systems and keep to the left systems and staff only pass this point systems. So luckily I made it, but it did take longer than I thought it was. It's quite embarrassing, really.
In the open waters, all alone, you're the only author.
So my whole system for the studying here is I study sort of like reading and problem questions and like actually answering questions in my room because I have my monitor and all my books. And then in the study spaces like the library and the TLC, that's where I listen to the lectures because I have no distractions there. That's sort of like how I divide up the workload and separate out the places that I study. Another good thing about being at Durham is that this city
feels completely safe. I think it's one of the safest in England. But yeah, honestly, I could be walking out here at any time and I never, ever, ever feel threatened. But you know, to be honest, I'm still not completely used to just how eerie it is here. You know, it's not even 10 o'clock yet and there's absolutely no one in the streets, where obviously in normal times it would be absolutely packed. But anyways, just got back to Hatfield. Gonna walk over to Bailey House and then we'll call it a day. Nothing like a good evening walk. So yeah, that was another day in the life of a Durham University law student. Obviously, it's not as interesting as most other years. No societies, no sport during lockdown, no lectures that are in person. If you want to see anything else during my time here, then obviously let me know in the comment section below as well. But other than that, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.
But we just running around, chasing the lettuce. I bought a Bentley, still feel pathetic. Glass on my wrist, still feel depression. Music my therapy, it's my obsession. Spitting these bars, handing out lessons. Don't go to church, but I'm making confessions. Fly like a bird, making impressions. I got the answers, just give me your